Welcome back, YTV Bae. I told you, with this relaunch, I was not coming to play. The relaunch of Yell at Diamond TV includes so much, but today's topic is for my men and my women. We're gonna be discussing what women really want in a man. All different age groups, not just my perspective being a 21-year-old black female, but what does a 30-year-old woman want in a man? What does a 40-year-old woman want in a man? When you hit that 25-year-old mark, what does that woman really want in a man? So, man, I'm going to help y'all out too, because I know you've been buying roses, getting cards, taking her to the finest restaurants. What do we really want? What do we really want? So, I know that a lot of people come from different backgrounds, different credit scores, different parts of life. We've all experienced different things. When you get a certain age, does those desires that you're looking for in that man change? When you experience certain stuff, does what you're looking for in a man change? We're gonna find out. So we're about to go hunt down different age groups of women, all types of women, big, small, bodied, unbodied, unshaped, everything, and find out what these women looking for. What are we really looking for?
So, what do women want from men? That is age-old question, because as women, I think our desires change as we get older. Because back in the day, I wanted somebody that looked good, had a lot of money, all this other stuff. Now I want somebody that's faithful, consistent about me, our family, and his responsibilities. Someone that's God-fearing, and that's just gonna push me to do better and better spiritually and any other way possible. If he sees me lacking in something, I hope that he tells me and he doesn't try to sugarcoat it or go find it from somebody else, because that's what little boys do. Men actually step up all the way up and push their women to do better. That's what I want from a man. Nothing more, nothing less. He doesn't have to make all the money in the world, but I at least want to know that he's trying.
Jaleesa actually answered one of my main questions. Will the things I'm looking for in a man now change within the next 5, 10, 15 years? And her answer is yes. Let's see what the next person has to say.
Stability, trust, and honesty. I feel like with trust and honesty, trust goes a long way. If I can't trust you, then why would I even want to be around you? If I can't trust you, then I shouldn't be dating you. I don't want to only trust you some days, and some days I trust you, some days I don't. I want to be able to trust you every day, because trust takes the relationship a long way. Also, stability. I know if my man ever falls short, I'm there to help him pick up the pieces, and I just will want my man to do the same for me, because people often say, oh, their relationship is 50-50. I don't feel like that. I feel like their relationship is 100-100 or 1,000-1,000, because we both have to give the full effort in order for our relationship to grow, in order for our bond to stay strong.
The things that a woman more than likely wants in a man is financial security. No matter how much money a woman makes, of course she wants somebody that can take care of the household, can take care of her as well, and whatever money the woman makes, I believe that's money that should be saved up for a rainy day. Women love attention. Take her on dates, give her flowers. Always treat her like you're trying to get her, like how you did in the beginning. Thirdly, women also want security. Somebody they can feel safe with, feel like that can protect them, protect their family, and who's not scared to throw themselves in front of her if needed to be protected. And lastly, knock her rocks off really good. Like, you know, diddle the skittles every now and again, but don't get bored.
So, I would want a man who could match my energy. If I'm giving everything and then some, I want you to give everything above and beyond. I also want a strong man who can handle an independent woman, because I don't need rescuing. I want somebody who I can build with, who I can go through situations with, and we still come out together on top of the situation. And I want someone who actually wants a relationship.
Men, young and old, I hope you took notes, because these ladies were 100% sure of what they're looking for in a man. This video, I didn't want to call concentrate on me. I want to see what my followers, supporters, and viewers were looking for in a man. I might can play Cupid though and hook some of y'all up, but this video wasn't really about me. I noticed, regardless of the age gaps, each woman were looking for three main things: stability, comfort, and honesty. I noticed all the women mentioned something about those characteristics, even if it wasn't directly mentioned. So men, are you honest? Do you have some stability to offer? Is she gonna be carrying all the weight on her shoulders? Are you protective? Are you secure in your life? Where are you in life? How old are you? I feel like all the things these ladies mentioned, and I want to thank you guys for volunteering to do that for me, are 100% of what most women would agree to. These are what the things we are looking for in a man, especially a future husband. That is one of the key points I want to mention. These are things a man, not little boys like Jaleesa said, are looking for. As Majesty mentioned, I don't need nobody to come rescue me. I need somebody on my level. We want somebody on our level. We don't need a rescuer. That's not what we're looking for in a relationship. So men, I hope you had your notepads and you took some notes. And ladies, if you have anything else you want to add, drop some comments and I will gladly reiterate them on my Instagram and my YouTube channel. Lastly, I want to take a moment and answer a question that I was asked that relates to the topic of what women want in a man. I was asked lately, who's my favorite ex-boyfriend and why? First, I would like to say I'm not ashamed to acknowledge who my favorite ex-boyfriend is and provide the reasons why. I won't mention any names, but my favorite ex-boyfriend will be the one who taught me the most unintentionally. So the guy who I dated for 3 years, I believe it was 3 years, is my favorite ex. Not for any physical reasons, not for any emotional reasons, but for the lessons that I learned while dating him. And they weren't all bad experiences. He's not the worst person on the planet. I do not hate him, wish him the best, but I learned a lot about myself, a lot of things about me that I didn't know before. I learned my worth. I learned what to put up with and what not to put up with in a relationship, what to expect from a man versus a little boy. I learned a lot of things that I went in unprepared to learn. So he taught me a lot of things that prepared me for later relationships, and I actually did better in certain areas because of my experience with dating him. So I really appreciate the experience I got from him. You all should be willing and self-aware, not insecure, to talk to your new mate about some of the things you experienced with your old mate so that those same things don't occur in your new relationship. Don't be scared to open up about old mates. I feel that's very important. Old experiences help establish new foundations. We need to know, where were those errors? What did I mess up last time? Those are important things. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I hope you're already subscribed and you're not just watching this, because this is only gonna get better. This relaunch is serious. Like, it's only gonna get better. Subscribe, follow me on Instagram at YeahThatDiamondTV. Thank you.